In this free training video, I want to talk about a modification or upgrade that you can make to your own FileMaker database, or maybe make even to your own copy of FM Starting Point. Now, starting with FileMaker 12 and carried forward to newer versions of the FileMaker platform is the ability for digital document management. This is a fundamental improvement to the FileMaker platform that allows users to drag and drop documents like PDFs or Word documents or photos or even movies into a FileMaker container field and have that information stored efficiently on a FileMaker server. Now, we've actually covered this in other free training and also at great length in our FileMaker Pro 13 training course. And even in our free FM Starting Point starter solution, we've made digital document management available for people who want to get started with their own custom FileMaker solution. And this makes the jumping off point for this video. I'm going to go ahead and look at the Contacts module here in FM Starting Point, and I can click the Digital Documents tab right here, and I can see that I have these digital document windows ready to go right here. I can take an image, for example, and drop it right on there, and it's ready to go. And notice that I have six here, and then I have slide panels that are ready to go to add additional documents. And so, of course, if you look at this, you understand that we have three slide panels, each with six containers. That gives us about 18 documents that we can have for this contact, which is Ryan Alvarez Smith. Now, a handful of you have contacted me over the last number of months and said, hey, that's just not enough documents for my business model. I need to have more containers, more flexibility. I can't be hamstrung by that. Well, the reason we developed the containers in this fashion is because that in the base copy of FM Starting Point, we want to make sure that the underlying database is simple to understand and easy for you to customize. If I go into layout mode here, by pressing Command or Control L on the keyboard, you can see that the software is pretty straightforward. If I go back to the first slide panel right here, you can see that we actually have the fields right here, and it's pretty easy to understand that I actually have a slide control here. I can double click and I actually have three slide panels right here. And I could actually add another slide panel and add additional containers. So it's pretty slick, but it is limited. So how do we improve this? Well, to actually add unlimited containers is a little bit of a hack. And I want to point out a great demo by Matt Petrowsky of ISO FileMaker Magazine, who about 6 or 7 months ago put out a great demo called Endless Picture Sliders, which actually produces the exact effect that you're looking for. Now, the reason we haven't put it into FM Starting Point is, once again, while a handful of people would like to have this, under the hood, it's a little bit deep. In fact, it's actually kind of a lot deep. And so if you're a FileMaker developer, you're probably going to be at least an intermediate and maybe an intermediate developer that's heading towards being an advanced developer before you can really understand what's going on here. That doesn't mean that you can't hijack the solution and wire it into your own copy of Starting Point. Sometimes you can get something wired into your own solution without really understanding how it works under the hood. Or you can get another developer to help do that for you so you can take advantage of the technology. Every astronaut in NASA's space program didn't understand how every computer system and every rocket component worked before they took off in the space shuttle and went into orbit. So just keep that in mind. So I want to spend a moment and show you this endless picture sliders and give a great shout out to Matt Petrowsky, who did this solution. It's really slick. And also keep in mind, if you're looking for more advanced training, Matt Petrowsky offers his own advanced video course called ISO FileMaker Magazine, which is available at FileMakerMagazine.com. And it is a monthly subscription that you're going to pay for, but it does come out with a quality video every couple weeks with an appropriate sample file that's attached to it. It's really good content. Now, I'm going to make a copy of this Endless Picture Sliders file available on RCC's website. And I've got permission for Matt to do this. But I want to be clear with everyone that if you want a detailed explanation under the hood about how this file works, he does have a video that talks about this. But I want to be upfront and tell you the kinds of things you're going to need to know. You're going to need to be familiar with the list function in FileMaker and the idea of multi-keys between your parent and child records. You're also going to have a good grasp of scripting and how to manipulate global fields and variables. All these types of things we've addressed in our FileMaker Pro 13 video course at learningfilemaker.com. So I definitely recommend that if you haven't spent the time to learn the fundamentals with that video course, I would recommend that you check it out before you get too deep into things. That being said, I want to show you this right here. So I'm going to fire up the file right here. And as you can see, this is the end of those picture sliders. You can see that this appears to be a slide control, or at least it quacks and acts like a slide control. And as I click left and right here, it appears that the slide panels are sliding left to right. Now in reality, what's happening here is that this is only three slide panels. I'm going to drop into layout mode and show this to you real quick, just so you have a general thumbnail understanding of what's happening here. And this is all from the brains of Matt Petrowsky. And once again, it's brilliance under the hood for someone to come up with this. But Matt uses the left and the right side of the slide control simply to capture the swipe gesture on an iOS device. It's pretty slick. On the desktop computer, it's less critical because all you're generally going to do is press the mouse button to activate the slide function. But what's happened here is that as we entered the layout here, the onLayout enter script trigger tells the system to navigate to the middle slide panel. And then as we tell the system to go to the right slide panel here, we don't actually go to the right, but a relationship here in the middle that regulates this container jumps to the next related record. So we're moving to the next related record. So these are related containers in a separate table. So another related container in a separate table. Another related container. And there's, of course, Matt Petrowsky's smiling face. And his smiling face after he's had too much crack at home. Or we have to cut him back on his caffeine intake, whichever it is. So the point is that these buttons actually regulate the relationship back and forth. These dots down here are completely a fake facsimile of the dots that you would normally get on a slide control. So once again, this whole apparatus here quacks and acts like slide panels or a slide control. And it actually is three separate slide panels, but it's not behaving the way that you think it does. As we click back and forth, we never actually leave this middle slide panel. All that happens is that the relationship changes, and the content then of this middle container right here changes, and we see different related values through that relationship. I'm not going to get too much deeper into this than that, because Matt does a good job of explaining it, and if you really want that much more detail, then you can pay him a couple bucks and watch the video from Matt. That being said, if you've been watching our training at learningfilemaker.com, and you've learned about value lists, and you've learned about multi-keys, and you've learned about scripting, then you should be in a good place to work on transporting this system into your own copy of FM Starting Point or into your own database itself. Individually, there's no craziness in here. There's lots of little scripts in here that do little things. And the biggest script is right here. And probably the biggest calculation is right here. And this is where the system is actually trying to calculate which related container you should see. And of course, that makes sense. As you press the left button or the right button, which container should you see? If you're all the way to the right, then it should jump back to the left. If you're all the way to the left and you press the left button, it jumps back to the right. And what if you're on one that you delete? Then what should you see? So there's some special cases that have to be accounted for. It's all pretty straightforward if you break it all down. Also keep in mind, if you're going to transplant this into your own solution, there's a number of script triggers between the layout script triggers that are here. There's three or four of them here. There's a number of them here for this object here. There's also a number of hidden objects that are set up here. All these script triggers need to be taken into account. So as users navigate onto this layout or they navigate between records, the system operates correctly. So once again, hats off to Matt Petrowsky for a very clever design that solves an important business problem that we've seen a number of times in the FileMaker community.